For 2 years, CBS 6 has been investigating abuse and neglect claims against staff members at the Cumberland Children's Hospital in New Kent County. Now, a former behavior technician is speaking out about an incident that the state investigated after we brought it to their attention.
In tonight's Problem Solvers investigation, she speaks to our Laura French. Why that former staff member says she's angry with the state's report on the way she and others handled a potentially violent patient.
The hospital is calling 911 to handle the behaviors of patients. That should be a huge red flag.
Investigators say that emergency call came from inside Cumberland Hospital on the night of June 3rd after a behavior technician and others were threatened by a teenage patient with a large piece of wood.
And I still remember the individual holding it like about 3 inches away from my neck and screaming at me as we're trying to de-escalate the situation. And the police wouldn't even go inside the same room as this individual without a taser and a riot shield and backup.
This Johns Hopkins University graduate nursing student, who we have agreed not to identify in order to protect the privacy of the patient, says staffing was part of the problem the night of that disorderly conduct call when she was working as a BT.
A code was called to deal with a patient that was becoming out of control. There was not a huge response because we were so short-staffed, and from responding to the code, the situation just continued to escalate, unfortunately.
As CBS 6 first told you back in June, the child was, according to this police report, locked in the day room by several staff members who were holding the door shut, the former BT being one of them.
I did what my supervisor asked me to do. When the police arrived before they engaged with the patient, they asked me to do it as well.
The patient reported to deputies he, quote, exploded after he claimed he wasn't being properly medicated and got into a heated dispute with a nurse. The Virginia Department of Behavioral Health and Developmental Services launched an investigation after CBS 6 brought the incident to their attention. They'd interview the former BT, or as they referred to her in this investigative report, staff number one.
I was livid when I found out about the report because I believe the way they put staff number one in there, it's entirely scapegoating.
The state ultimately found that Cumberland and staff number one failed to follow the hospital's seclusion policy when the patient was prevented from leaving a room and was given the perception that it was locked.
What I said fully was that I would have held the door if necessary because my supervisor and the police told me to do so.
But the part about who allegedly instructed her to hold the door never made it into staff number one's statement on the matter.
How does a regulatory body engage in what to me essentially looks like a cover-up? Because the way the report is written, one of the things that frustrates me the most is that it ends by saying staff member number one resigned before they could receive training. Well, I didn't leave because of this incident, but that's how it reads. I left to go to graduate school. It also says that the staff member was written up. I have never been written up a day in my life.
But what she says she did receive was plenty of written praise in her year and a half at the hospital. Recommendation letters expressed she was a, quote, wonderful asset to Cumberland and a team player. Words like honesty, integrity, and dependability were used to describe her. And she did some writing of her own during her tenure at the hospital.
In my opinion, Cumberland is choosing to be reactive as opposed to proactive.
Emails provided to CBS 6 show she had sent warnings to Cumberland's CEO and other staff members.
I feel as though Cumberland is waiting for something very serious or potentially irreversible to occur.
Of her concerns of a June 3rd type event or worse, starting last year up until weeks before the incident and after.
Me and a coworker were the only two employees responding to codes throughout the hospital. A patient or staff member is going to be critically injured if this situation continues.
Expressing that was inevitable if something didn't change.
What would your message to Cumberland be?
Change. I would say that wholeheartedly, the mission of Cumberland Hospital is a beautiful mission to treat people that both have physical ailments and mental health diagnoses. It is so critical, the mission is, and they are failing in that mission. And it's unacceptable.
And her message to the state?
Be thorough. Like, honestly, I laughed because I want to say do your job. Because my thing is, it's your regulatory body. You set the standards. You show us what's acceptable and unacceptable by how you deliver consequences. There has to be consequences for failing the patients. There has to be someone somewhere doing something to help these individuals that are supposed to be getting care in this hospital, and what they're really getting is more trauma.
DBHDS provided CBS 6 with a detailed account of its investigative process on this incident, which we provided on our website. They added, quote, licensed providers have the opportunity to dispute the facts and findings of a citation report. However, Cumberland Hospital did not dispute this citation. We also reached out to Cumberland. The CEO said, quote, the former employee referenced in the report left our organization to pursue another opportunity. We cannot offer additional comment on employment matters. Much more on WTVR.com.